What is the difference between the traditional test pyramid and an agile test pyramid? This is the traditional test pyramid. The traditional test pyramid is used in waterfall processes. There, we also use the V model for testing. I showed you in my previous video about the traditional testing versus the agile testing that in the V model, we have a very long time between requirements engineering and implementation, and then also again a very long time between implementation and the testing. This comes up to this test pyramid which we are seeing here. If we only have a few unit tests which are done by the developer, then we have a little bit more integration tests for external services, API and also single user interfaces, and we have a lot of end-to-end tests. This is caused by the V model, because now we do a lot of testing at the end when the feature has been implemented. We do there these tests manual. We execute all of the test cases. This, as you can see, is very slow. That's also why we usually have at release cycles 6 weeks of testing phases, because we do a lot of manual testing. And this manual testing is not only slow, it's also very expensive. And we only have a few unit tests which are cheap and fast to execute. So that's also the problem of the traditional test pyramid. The focus of the traditional test pyramid is completely on finding bugs. Let's see how the agile testing pyramid looks like. This is the agile test pyramid. Because we are using behavior-driven development and test-driven development, we always first write a test and then we write the functionality. This causes that we have a lot of unit tests and also a lot of integration tests on the external services, on the APIs, and also on single user interfaces. We only have a few end-to-end tests, preferably, of course, automated. They are more or less some smoke tests which go through the process end-to-end. The main focus of the agile test pyramid is to prevent bugs and to enable us to have a fast feedback. Before we saw the agile test pyramid, my recommendation for the test pyramid looks like this. I made a lot of experience during the past years of software development, and what I could see is that having a lot of unit tests is also not good, because it tightens very much your application. So my recommendation to you is to go and implement the tests on your API level. So have a lot of tests on the API level and only a few tests on the unit test level. And then, of course, we also have some smoke tests, which are then the end-to-end UI tests, which are also preferably automated. This ensures in your application a good maintainability of the whole application and, of course, also of the tests. Please leave me a like if you liked this video, and don't forget to subscribe, because I do every week a new video for you.